Hello there, everybody. I'm going to be reviewing the mini deep fryer I just bought from Lidl yesterday. It was £19.99. The price, not the year. And we're going to go over the quality of it. I'm going to put some oil in it, get it going. And a bit of safety I'm going to talk about as well, because I learnt some very shocking news today. Kitchen safety, fire safety, electrical safety surely should be given a bit more thought, because that sort of information is going to save your life, maybe. There's so many aspects of safety that I need to go over whilst doing this that I'm not really sure where to start. But I suppose the best place to start is my education on safety when I was growing up and what I learnt when I was at school. I was taught in Hull, putting the emphasis on the H there for Hull, which is often derided in the UK as a city. It's often the bottom of education league tables, and nothing is really done about that, but it just is. However, I was really shocked to hear that the state of education seems to have got even lower when it comes to safety. And also, it can even be ridiculous, because the amount of electrical products we see just tossed out, so often what could be the case is the fuse just needs changing in the plug. But kids are not being taught that these days. And it's, well, that's bad for the environment. That little bit of information could save a whole lot of damage to the environment. So why are you not teaching it as part of the environmental studies or whatever being taught nowadays? You see what I mean? Everything is connected. Anyway, this deep fat fryer. Now, deep fat fryers I would consider as being one of the most dangerous items you can have in the kitchen. We've got the instruction book, and what I would like to see these days on anything to do with electrical safety, and particularly with fryers, is it shouldn't really even be in black and white. It should be a strip saying the basic items of what to do should this catch fire. It shouldn't be used by children under the age of 8. I think even that is too young, to be honest with you. We're talking about hot oil here. Where's the fire? Never use water to extinguish a fire in the deep fat fryer. This is the point, and we have to get to page 6 to get to it. Old or dirty fats and oils can spontaneously ignite if overheated. Change the oils or fats regularly. In the case of a fire, remove the plug from the mains power socket and smother the burning fat or oil with a damp towel or fire blanket. Very few people have a fire blanket in their house. And when I was talking to my family member, she said that's all I was really told to do, really. It was very loosely covered. When I was at primary school, there were several videos we watched, and there was also a BBC TV programme called Nan Nan Nan, and it was presented by Michael Burke, and it showed you countless amount of people being stupid, still, then, trying to use water to put out a fire that is oil. And I'm going to demonstrate for you why you shouldn't do that. A very short demonstration here of what happens, and what I was annoyed that my family member wasn't told when she was at school. And I think this point is rather serious, and why we should have been, well, I was, but why she should have been taught this. This is 250ml of vegetable oil, and this is 175ml of water. Now, usually, when the oil's on fire, there's going to be a lot of it. Now, oil is obviously different from water. Let's pretend that this oil is on fire. There's a lot of oil there, and when this is burning, it's an oil fire. By being an idiot and throwing water onto the oil, what you'll find is that now the oil is floating on top of the water. What would happen is, if this was on fire, as I was pouring that water in, some of the water would evaporate instantly with little parts of oil mixed into it, which would be on fire. That would cause a cloud of fire, oil burning fire. Because of the volume of water that was just chucked in, Some of the water would reach the bottom, but wouldn't be there very long, and would instantly heat above 100 degrees C, shooting up, and that's what also causes the fireball with oil and fats. Never throw water on oil. Never do it. Look at the difference. All of the oil here that would be on fire would now be setting everything on in the kitchen on fire. And also, because it's an oil fire, it would burn through your skin more than boiling water, because obviously this is twice as hot as what this is, at the very least. Mixed with oxygen in the air, it's probably even hotter. That is why you don't mix it. There we are. I hope I've helped. I don't mean to put anyone off buying a fat fryer, because it's a really good way to cook things. But the reason why I'm saying all that is because I watched a YouTube video, and it was like one of them Phil's videos. And it was a fast food place, and the oil had caught fire. And some stupid moron threw water on it. And unfortunately, he wouldn't have just injured himself, but everybody around him. That is how dangerous a fire can be. And I was so angry when I saw it, because I thought, this is somebody working in a food preparation place who doesn't even know how to put out an oil fire. I was so angry when I saw it, because it was in a fail video, and I bet some people laughed when they saw it. There we go. Push down button. Inside, what I've got is a basket, apparently. This is going to lead on to the second thing. That cable's a bit thin. Really. You see, for flat fryers and kettles and everything, I just think a thicker cable, a chunkier cable, would make me feel safer, because there's a kettle that I got from Lidl that's got this similar cable on it. And the cable gets warm. And I don't like that. It doesn't really make you feel very safe. The other thing about safety then is my family member wasn't told about fuses, which is another very dangerous thing. I've got a basket and it's got a mark on there saying what's the maximum level of food. Inside, this is meant to be non-stick. No, I just find it really infuriating that they're not teaching kids these days how to wire a plug or change a fuse. Incredibly wasteful for the environment, isn't it? All this plastic, aluminium and glass in the lid. All this just going into landfill because at school they're not teaching kids how to change a fuse. I mean, obviously this is very cheap electronics. We're getting more and more of them thanks to supermarkets and obviously online. And there we go, that's the basket sorted. That is the basket sorted. There we go. Is it in? Yeah, that's in. A bit rickety. I've got a feeling that that's not going to last. Is that in now? Is that it? Oh, that's it. You're supposed to do that. Oh, that's a bit more, but still a bit... Oh, well, that's in. I'm going to give this a clean down before we use it. Very thin plug. Oh, it just doesn't give me confidence. I don't know why. I just don't feel confident with it. Right, I'm going to put the oil in whilst it's turned off. On the front, we've got a switch for on and off. And we've got a dial for the heat, which there's a lot of play in that. For instance, is that 90 degrees or is that 90 degrees? Do I turn it back for the 90 degrees? That's, yeah, but 20 quid, what can you say? Anyway. I've actually got some sweet potato fries. I'm going to put in this. Sweet potato chips is what I'd like to say. 1.2 litres, it says. I want to mention Lidl a lot. If you haven't mentioned it already or if it's somehow got edited out, this is not a paid for promotion. None of my videos are paid for promotions or anything. It's all stuff bought by me and reviewed by me. It's as if you bought it yourself. Is how I do my reviews, because I don't want to be even subconsciously swayed by anyone's input. Now, I do subscribe to How to Cook That. And she does go through the benefits and the negatives of cooking with oil. The reason why they use it in restaurants is because it's a very, very quick way of cooking things. Very quick. However, it's obviously unhealthy. And it's not the cheapest. It's not the most expensive, I don't think, but it's not the cheapest. Yeah, I'm just coming up to the max lan now. There we go. The oil cost £1.09 per bottle. I already had a little bit left already from a while ago. Let's turn it on. Let's see if it explodes. That'll make a more interesting YouTube video, wouldn't it? Well, I've turned it on the wall. And now let's turn it on at the front. And it didn't explode. What I've got is two lights on the front. Let me just scooch down a bit and move that back a bit. I've got a power and a ready light that's on because I've not turned it up. And there we go. Now it should start heating up. I'm going to be doing sweet potato chips. And it says for that I should be on the 170 degrees. I'm going to let that do its thing. It's got a filter that is changeable, apparently, or cleanable, whatever. Yeah, this is actually the first fryer I've ever actually bought. That's how much I've got in. That is practically, how many bags? 500 gram, really, bag. And I've got a few left, but I don't want to go over the max lan. Yeah, I don't want to go over the max lan. Sweet potato chips. I've got in there probably, 400 gram? But I am going to talk about another thing about safety when cooking, and that's making sure you've got something on your feet. I got these from Lidl, would you have guessed? This is the first time I've bought shoes from Lidl, because usually by the time I get there, it's usually only the ridiculous large size left, or the incredibly small size left. But I was very surprised to see that they had my size in. Look. 11.5 is the size it says on here. I tried them on, and it probably is a more of a size 11. But my feet are really wide, and it's nice because I call it stretchy, elasticy sort of stuff, and they're really light. Yes, the reason why you have something on your feet is not just in case of splashes, because obviously if oil did fall on any material, really, it's going to somehow get to you. But the point of the fact is to make sure that you're not in your socks on slardy lano or slardy laminate floor or anything like that. You've got to make sure that your feet are steady on the floor, so when you're moving hot food around and oils or cooking or anything like that, and if you drop anything on your feet, you can maybe jump out the way quicker and safely before it actually lands on your feet. Ooh, nice and comfy, lovely. Oh, my feet are so wide. It's bulging over the sides already. Very annoying. But not as annoying as that flipping motorbike. Well, that was quite quick. It says it's ready already. That's good. The sun's just gone behind a cloud. Yeah, that's not going to affect the lighting so much. I'm expecting a noise. There we go. Ooh, clicky, clicky, clicky. That's given a bit of a wobble because one chip's not in there. There we go. And 3 to 4 minutes, it says these are going to cook. Just 3 to 4 minutes. Oh, that's really dodgy. That don't click shut very well. That don't click very shut well at all. That's a bit... Well, that's not good, is it? Yes. I suppose the quality is going to be a bit strange, but... I suppose what's going to happen there is I'd need a wooden spoon to flip that open, because that's actually annoyed me already. Wooden spoon, wooden spoon. Why can't I find anything that I need in this flipping drawer? Don't you just hate that drawer in the kitchen that's got your different random utensils in that you don't use very much and you can never find what you want? I found it. I found a wooden spatula. That'll do. Good grief. So 3 to 4 minutes. I want to cut that from like now. Right, as they're cooking, the window's steamed up a bit, so that's not the greatest of use. I'm just starting to get a bit of steam, or vapour rather, or whatever, out the filter. I'm just going to put on the extractor fan. We're going to have to put up with that noise because I don't particularly want the kitchen smelling of oil. You've got to have a nice bowl ready with some kitchen roll flung in to catch any remaining oil. Because you don't want to eat direct from fryer. If these was normal chips made from potato, I would probably get some chip spice as well. But these are sweet potato chips, and it doesn't really need the chip spice as much. This is really strange because I've been so used to doing oven chips, which obviously you've got to turn the oven on, which takes a good 10 minutes to get to temperature. Put the chips in, then that takes another, maybe depending on the kind of chips you've bought, that can be anywhere from another 15 to 20 minutes to cook them. And then obviously you've got that wasted heat just milling around in your oven. These are supposed to be ready now. Yeah, I'm not enjoying that at all. The way the lid works, I've got all this residue now just running onto the counter behind it. I'm going to turn it off. Because they should be done. And they are. That's like a revelation to me. I know that might sound bizarre, but I've never used a fryer before, and I'm amazed how quick they've cooked. I have got some fish fingers to cook as well, but I thought for now, I thought I'd just do the chips. It does have a resting hook thing, so you can let them drain. It's very important that you remember to straight away turn it off on the wall as well. Now, I know that's a very UK thing apparently to do, but we have switches on the wall for safety. I am a subscriber to Technology Connections as well, and I think his videos are great, but he's not really in favour of switches on the wall. He says that, well, it's got a switch on the appliance and blah, 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 blah. But the way I see it is, what if this fails? I don't trust cheap electronics enough that their switches on the system are enough to turn it off properly. I've already spoken about the thinner wire that seems to be used, within a cable rather. I prefer to have it switched off at the wall, because then it is that is now completely isolated. There's no way that is now going to be live in any way. I just feel safer. It's a safer way of doing things. Anyway, let's get them out there now. I don't feel confident shaking this. I don't want it to drop off into the oven and splatter oil everywhere. That's obviously nearly 200 degrees Celsius. Let's tip them in. See what I mean? Look! The basket's coming off! This is very hot, so obviously I'm not going to touch that. Even with my asbestos fingers that I've often mentioned, dry heat is different to a liquid. I don't like that. That's not very good at all. I mean, very stupid. Anyway. Yeah, don't do what I'm doing. Just don't do it. Okay? They're all stuck in there. Because these are hot. There's going to be like 200 degree. What the hell is this? Couldn't they have made this any safer? That is very dangerous. I don't like that. Right, I'm just going to put that down somewhere. There we go. Let's try the chips. Here we go. Done. The excess oil falls into your kitchen roll. I love the speed of cooking in a fryer. And obviously the taste is going to be great as well, and you know they're going to be cooked because it's been in 200 degrees direct with the oil. They are
they're hot. And if that's after a couple of minutes of them being in this. I love sweet potato. These are very good. Don't get out of your car. So they're just bibbing. What I need now is a gun. No, what I need now is some salt to try these. Oh my god, what is it? Pump them and poople. Close the window and I can still hear it. Oh, somebody really needs a knuckle sandwich. Anyway, I put on some pink Himalayan salt. That I got from Aldi, I think. but yeah. Delicious. Faults with it. I don't like the basket. The basket is dangerous, I think. The basket is a bit dangerous. It's almost as if someone made the machine separate from the basket. I've just had a go at fixing it. And it's refusing to snap into this side bit. And I don't trust the quality of the basket enough for it to go together properly. I think that's going to be an issue. And I'm going to end up having to use tongs to pull the basket out in the future, I think. The lid didn't close properly because of the basket. I think that's everything I've got to say for it. I love it. I think it's great for 1 to 2 people to cook some dinners in it and whatnot. What this is going to do is portion control, which is my biggest problem I have. I love food and I love cooking. But my problem is I like northern portions, which usually is a lot. I sometimes wonder in a previous life, was I a whale? Thanks for watching. Scrass Bellamy. Bye.